So good evening, everyone. Welcome to the wonderful episode of PSI Community. And before I start, I'll say Namaskar, Sat Sri Akal, Adab to all my eminent community members. A very good evening and a hearty welcome. I, Deepak Srivastav, welcome you to the 21st learning session organized by the PSI, the Public Speaking Institute Community, with a vision to bring eminent speakers from different fields who can add value to your life by sharing their knowledge and situations which they have been through using the power of communication. I take special privilege to welcome the new members and guests on behalf of the PSI Core Committee. May I request everyone, if they are guests, to please add guest before your name in case if you are invited to attend this session. Before we move on, let me just introduce you to the vision, mission and objective of the PSI. The PSI's vision is to have at least one public speaker in every home who can inspire the entire family. The mission of PSI is to have 1 million public speakers by the year 2030. So this is not just the mission of PSI, this is the mission of our founder as well. We'll talk about him as well. And the objective of PSI is to promote public speaking, presentation skills, effective communication, storytelling skills, mental skills, etc., etc. Oh, long list. And I am pleasure to inform you that the wonderful PSI community has professional speakers, public speakers, anchors, authors, coaches, trainers, influencers, startup business owners, professionals, educators. Oh, a lot more. Kindly follow the rules as under. First, maintain the decorum of the forum. Do not unmute yourself unless you are invited or asked for, and keep your question answers for the end. And now let's talk about the person who is behind this PSI community. And I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Arthur Sherry sir, the visionary founder and managing director of Public Speaking Institute community of around 2.5 lakh public speakers across the globe, and who is also pioneering to give India its first public speaking university. He is a well-known international public speaking coach and mentor and has created 15,000 plus public speakers across the world, and is 7 times international TEDx speaker, 3 times Joe Stock speaker, and author of international bestsellers. May I request everyone to please unmute themselves and let's give a big round of applause to Arthur Sherry, founder and managing director of Public Speaking Institute. Coming to today's topic, what I feel, relationship means connection. The strong relationships contribute to a long, healthy, and happy life. The more closely we are connected to the people we love, the happier we feel, and more personal satisfaction we have in our lives. Relationship teaches us basics of happy living, being patient, caring, loving, and being supportive as well. Our public relations, in simple words, is the art and science behind the science of building relationships between an organization and its key audiences or the public, which we are. It is also key to quickly distribute information and generate awareness among large audiences. In the current fast-growing market, PR has become an essential part of marketing communications. It influences the performance and or promotes business or a person through a variety of channels. So let us hear more from the expert from it. And today, the August personality I'm going to invite started her professional journey in 2016 with public relations. She had worked across various verticals and brands in the following years, including Emirates India, American Express, UC Browser, Pacific Mall, the Lalit Hotel, etc., etc. She is a public relations consultant, soft skill trainer, life coach, NLP practitioner, as well as an anchor. She herself calls herself as a lifelong learner, and in these years, she has come across various professions and got into opportunity to add different feathers to her hat. She loves to take training on various topics of soft skills, business communication. She conducts training for aspiring communication students, startups, entrepreneurs, and business professionals also. She is none other than Miss Manpreet Kaur, who loves to travel, write, and sing. And I would reveal one thing. She had done graduation in Indian classic music too. Sorry, Indian classical music also. Please join me to welcome Miss Manpreet Kaur with a big round of applause.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful introduction. And along with that, you made my job a little more easier. You talked about public relations, like gave a brief. So that was really like, that was a cherry on the cake, I believe. Thank you so much for that. So can I quickly start, if you guys allow? Thank you. My screen visible?
Yes.
If I can get thumbs up. Okay. So I'm here to add to what you know already. I'm sure that you guys have heard about advertising, marketing, public relations, social media. We all are aware about these words. I am here to give you a little trigger or a little jolt, I would say, that are you using the right strategy for your brand? Are you using the effective strategy that can help leverage your brand? So it's all about importance of public relations and social media. It's all about effectively using different tools and strategies to leverage the image of your brand in media and market. Let me just put my home screen, yeah. So what is the need of the brand? The need of the brand is to effectively communicate, to share the key messaging in the most appropriate manner. And how that happens, there are various channels and tools, like I mentioned before. There are three main channels for that. One is advertising, another is marketing, third is PR, public relations. Essentially, it's all about key messaging. It's all about sharing the vision and mission in the most effective manner. So let's move quickly and discuss about that, what exactly public relations is. I am going to emphasize on more and more PR. I'm going to touch upon advertising. I'm going to touch upon marketing. However, the core strength that I have is PR. And I'm sure that by the end of the session, you guys will be like that, are we using the right strategy for the brand? Okay, so what is PR? Anybody who would like to unmute and give their inputs, like just a brief, anything that would help.
Come on, everyone, she's waiting.
Maybe Deepak, only you can add. Since I believe you have read and understood more. So I think if you can add a little bit, like in a very layman language, we don't want fancy definitions. It's there. We don't want that. Just a very basic and brief of what you know.
It is the art of building relationships.
Awesome. Yes. So it is effective storytelling. It is all about persuading people, persuading media, and sharing the key messaging. Let's take example of PSI only. PSI has different, PSI has a mission, PSI has a vision, PSI has a key messaging that they want to share with their public, with their target audience. So public relation person helps to share that key messaging in the most effective manner via using different tools. If you see PSI in a newspaper, a big snippet, a small snippet or a big format story, how that comes, either by advertising or by PR. So that is something that we'll be learning about. There are several definitions available on Google. There are several definitions given by different PR consultants, PR practitioners. But what I have learned in these 5-6 years, PR is nothing but about handling, reforming, and sustaining. And how does that happen? That happens by nurturing. Like we nurture our kid in a very similar manner. In a very similar manner, we have to nurture the brand that we work for. If we ourselves are brand, then we have to nurture it in the most effective manner. If we are working for some brand, then we have to nurture that. So it is all about handling, reforming, sustaining by nurturing. So, but there are people who tend to get confused between advertising, marketing, PR. So there is a thin line that I want to emphasize on, because we are like, अगर ये एड हमने देखा है तो ये एडवर्टाइजिंग से आया होगा, ये पीआर से आया होगा, दैट देयर आर लॉट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन दैट हैपेंस. सो फॉर दैट आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ टेबल एंड टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड इन द मोस्ट सिंपलेस्ट मैनर दैट व्हाट इज एडवर्टाइजिंग एंड व्हाट इज पीआर. एंड देयर इज अ थिन लाइन. एडवर्टाइजिंग इज पेड, पब्लिक रिलेशंस इज अर्नड. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट पीएसआई, इफ दे गिव अ बिग एड इन द न्यूज़पेपर एंड पे फॉर दैट, दैट इज पेड एड. इफ Sherry sir is using his relationship, or Sherry sir is using his image and getting a snippet, getting a story in the newspaper or website, that is PR. Advertising builds exposure. However, public relations build trust, the trust that you need. In advertising, audience is skeptical, but in PR, the third person is coming into the picture. Like, if I want to, talk about my brand, let's say if I want to talk about this phone, let's say. So somebody coming, I am putting a big ad in newspaper and I am saying, just buy this phone because this has these XXXXXX features. So that is not bringing that credibility. That is not making my brand authentic, because I am patting my own back. I am blowing my own trumpet. That is not we do. That is not PR people do. In PR, I am going to share the press release, or I'm going to share the announcement with the journalist. Journalist will see the pros and the cons. Journalist will see the features in every possible thing. And based on their experience, they'll be writing about the phone. So it is not like they will not, somebody is coming in the picture, the third party is coming in the picture and talking about your brand. So that brings credibility. Advertising is guaranteed placement. If you pay for it, you get guaranteed placement. But PR is all about earning. If the journalist see that, okay, this story is worth taking, this story has the potential to get covered, then only you get covered, else not. Media controls final version. In public relations, media controls the final decision. However, in advertising, it's all about putting graphics and it's all about like creative control. We must have seen Amul hoardings on the roads. So it's like, because they want to advertise, they have different graphics, they have a creative storytelling, amazing storytelling skills Amul has. So they put hoardings. However, if the spokesperson is coming and talking about their funding, talking about their expansion plans and whatnot, then that is PR. And public relations uses language. However, advertising is more of graphics. And PR is on top of everything. Like, PR is less expensive and advertising is more expensive in that comparison. Advertising will say, buy this product, this is good. Public relations will say, this is important if you want to buy. So they completely give you that authority to decide basis the credibility. They have told each and everything about the brand. Now you have to pick and choose that if you want to buy this or not. So I have given an example here. When Shah Rukh Khan says anything or everything, we get convinced easily, right? So Shah Rukh Khan coming onto TV and saying, Byju's is one of the best learning apps for kids. We tend to believe that, and it is actually. However, because the audience is very smart these days, they want to know more and more about the brand that they are associated with. So a publication like Your Story is a very well-known publication in New Age media. When they talk about the spokesperson who's come from a very humble background, who's a village boy, and he started his journey, and now he has 250 million net worth. Wow, that is amazing. So that brings more of credibility. That is PR, wherein we are not blowing our trumpet. Likewise, marketing is also different from PR. People tend to get confused between marketing and advertising and PR. Like, they think that all these things are similar. The goal is same, which is communication. However, the strategies are different. Marketing, the functioning is very, very different. They talk about sale. However, PR doesn't talk about sale. PR talk about relationship. PR talks about cultivating relationships. Target audience is very different. For marketing, the target audience is direct audience. But for PR, PR has media, PR has internal audience, PR has external audience. When I say internal audience, I mean the internal team that the company has. PR helps to have that harmony inside and outside. They you know, touch base your customer, but in a very indirect manner, not directly. They'll not go to the customer and say that, okay, buy this product, like I mentioned before. And last, the strategy of success metrics is also very, very different. Marketing talks about the numbers. PR talks about the visibility that they have got in media. So that is different. To make it more easy for you, marketing is all about, I am very smart. When I say that I am very smart, advertising is like, I am very smart, I am very smart. Like, it's about reiterating the same messaging. However, PR is when third person is coming into the picture and saying, trust me, he is very smart. So that brings more of credibility. So unfortunately, people are not very much aware about PR, and it's funny too. So that's why I've kept this. Like, I tend to get this question often from people when, you know, somebody who's outside India, let's say US. So that person is asked that, what do you do? That person says that I am into public relations. The other person would be like, wow. But in India, if you say that I am into public relations, they'll be like, hey, ye kya hota hai? That is something that we do get often. It's funny and unfortunate at the same time. So before we go ahead, I would like to ask a question. You have to come up with the brand that is in your room, like any brand. It could be any brand. We all of us are associated with different brands. So you just have to put the name of three brands that you can see in your room, any three brands. Anything. It could be tube light, AC, mobile phone, laptop, anything, washing machine, anything. Any three brands that you can see. Okay, Sherry so says MS Docs. Yeah, so very nice. And more. Okay. OnePlus. I am also gonna write. Okay, so all of us are associated with different brands around us, right? But one brand that is next to me, and that is common in the comment section. Surinder says iPhone. Surinderji says iPhone. I say Apple. So that is one of the common brands that we have got, right? So Apple. Apple has a very different strategy. The strategy that Apple has been using, there was a time when Apple does not used to go for ads on TV, but they used to go for PR. They have been going for PR since the very beginning. They have been using these four tools, and I believe these are very, very effective. And now, if you will hear them, you'll be like, yeah, it is super effective. That is why they are different from other gadgets, other phones. One, they don't announce their product date. They don't do it. They come up with a teaser. And they are like, we are coming up with a new flagship product. Are you interested in buying? Like, they don't ask you, are you interested in buying? You are interested in buying, right? And then that communication starts happening. People are talking about the new flagship product. People are like, wo naya phone aa raha hai, 12 Pro Max, 13, whatever. Because it, like, every year they come up with a new flagship one. So, and more or less the features are similar. However, we want to buy that because that is luxury. That used to be luxury. Now, we have, you know, EMI options and all of that. However, Apple is a statement symbol. One. So people are not talking, you are not talking about your brand. People are talking about your brand. They are talking about the teaser that you have shown. Now, media is interested to know that what is the date? What is the timeline? And that makes the brand different and unique. You are not talking about yourself. People are talking about you. The next strategy, scarcity. They don't come up with, you know, you must remember, mostly they launch their product near Diwali or Christmas, like October, November, December, holiday time. So whenever they launch their product, sorry, whenever they launch their product, what they do? You have, like, people see big queues in front of Apple stores and you are literally waiting, wearing mask or not or whatnot. You are waiting for the phone. Aap 10 din baad kharidoge tab bhi phone wahi rahega. But no, that excitement is there. So that they bring that scarcity and that they don't give all the products. They give like only 100 products are available, or let's say 1,000 products are available, and people have these big queues just to be like that. I'm the first person who got in my peer group, right? So that is another strategy that they use, scarcity. Third, it's like any other phone is phone. Lenovo is phone, MI is phone, Samsung is phone. They are not phone, they are iPhone. They have put themselves in a way that they are different from each and every phone available in the market. They are unique. Every other laptop is a laptop. They are not laptop, they are MacBook. So it's all about strategizing yourself in the best possible manner. I hope I'm clear. So people tend to think that, you know, like I have also talked about that, PR is all about getting media coverage and getting covered and all of that. But we tend to get confused. My screen is stuck for some reason. Just a sec. Okay, so people tend to get confused that we only handle media relations. However, we handle media relations. We handle if any event is happening of yours, we'll take care of it. We'll be handling your crisis communication. God forbid, it should not happen with any brand, but we do handle it. Community relations, reputation management. You're getting an image consultant who'll be there to handle your reputation. We handle your internal communication. We handle your external communication. We get you covered in print media. We get you covered in digital media. It's all about crafting and creative and exclusive strategy basis the need of your brand. That is the idea. What your brand needs, we'll craft it and create it in that manner, in the unique manner, and then you will get what you should get. Okay, so there are different tools that we use. Like I mentioned that, you know, you get featured in media, but how come do you get featured in media? That is the question. Media interviews, author article, big format, like corporate stories are happening, industry stories are happening. I'm going to talk more about it. And then there is any, you know, event happening. So there are different ways to get covered. It's just that we need to understand that what works best for us at this point in time. So I am going to talk about PSI as an example. If I want to promote PSI in media, there are three ways. There are three ways, basic three ways that we use. One is brand awareness. Second is corporate. Third is crisis communication. Brand awareness is all about highlighting the USPs of the brand, highlighting what is different, what is something different that Author Sherry is doing, what is some, like Public Speaking Institute is different from other institutes available who are serving the same service, but how they are different. So we tend to, you know, emphasize on the USP, and then we tend to create some meeting opportunities for our client. I'm going to create opportunity for my client wherein the spokesperson can go and meet the client, and I will be there. I will be there along with the client. I will be there, let's say about PSI only. I will be there with Sherry sir that, you know, whatever happens, I have to be there. He's meeting the journalist. And if in case the journalist is not interested right now to cover, he's not interested in July, but if he's gonna do a story in December, let's say, and author Sherry sir has met him like twice or thrice, he'll have that recall value. So we work on the long-term strategy. That is editorial meeting. So we create and cull out such opportunities that are relevant for our client. That is brand awareness. Second, industry story. Like I mentioned before, industry story is something, if let's say this story is happening, that how public speaking can bring a difference to your personality. And there are different public speakers commenting on the same topic. And that is called industry story. Industry story is not about when the one person comes and talks about their brand. That is corporate story. Industry story is something wherein different players are coming together and talking about their industry. Some industry story is happening, let's say. and they see that, okay, PSI has the potential to comment in this story. That is industry story. This is how we create such opportunities for our client that they are relevant for the media. Media roundtables. If let's say PSI is expanding and saying that we will be targeting tier 2 and tier 3 cities, and we are coming up with 15 institutes in India in the next 6 months, and the idea to open in tier 2 and tier 3 cities is to reach to the people who don't have that facility, who did not get a chance to, you know, use public speaking. Public speaking should be something that should be taught from the beginning itself, but still it's not there. So that's why PSI is reaching to tier 2 and tier 3 cities and coming up with 10-15 institutes in tier 2 and tier 3 cities, let's say. So that is the idea. Media roundtable. We'll be coming up with meetings. We'll be doing media conferences wherein the journalists and the editors are coming and interviewing Sherry sir and asking that, what is the agenda? What is your vision? What is your mission? And all of that. So that helps PSI get covered. That is brand awareness. Second is corporate visibility program. Now I have promoted PSI, and obviously with PSI, author Sherry is getting promoted, but there are a lot of people who have worked with Sherry sir in the background. They should also get that potential. They also have that potential to get covered, right? So corporate social responsibility is all about when we try and call out such opportunities where my client and their team members have the possibility to get covered. Let's say Kara ma'am can share an article with Times of India about public speaking. Herein, we don't need the founder. The co-founder or somebody from marketing or anybody else can come and pitch in. So we are building the brand. We are building the team in a way that everybody is relevant. Everybody is relevant. That is authored article. And in authored article, we never talk about our brand. We talk about industry. We talk something like, let's say there is a topic wherein that why soft skills are more important than hard skills, than technical skills. So that is a very beautiful topic. And it has been covered since ages. However, every time, every person who comes has a new perspective to add. So that is something that, you know, maybe Sherry sir or Kara ma'am can share their inputs on. I'm taking PSI example throughout, just like all of us can understand easily. Then profiling opportunities. Now, PSI has been covered. Sherry sir has been covered, wherein he's talking about his business. But there is an opportunity wherein he can be covered in soft profiling. Let's say he is inspiring people in different ways. He's not only inspiring people in public speaking. He can inspire people by saying that this is my daily routine. People are interested when you are there. And when people are talking about you, they are interested to know more about you. They are interested to know that what's your daily routine? At what time do you get up? If you are that personality. So we have to build ourselves in a way that people are interested in knowing about ourselves. And And then speakership opportunities. Speakership opportunities, nothing like we are doing these webinars, and you know, after COVID, webinar and podcast have become like, they were not that prevailing at some time back. Now they are very significant. There is a lot of potential for webinars and podcasts. So something like that, we get opportunities wherein our client can go and speak and be relevant. Then, this is a very new way. It was not there before. Let's say PSI is doing an event in partnership with Hindustan Times. Hindustan Times is one of the most read newspapers in India. But now PSI has been associated with HT or with Times of India or with Economic Times, and Economic Times is doing an event and PSI is the partner. Can you see the difference? PSI was always credible because it has content, because people had skills. And PSI was promoting people. PSI was teaching people, making people more skilled, and all of that was happening. But when a brand like HT is associated, if the image is here, it shoots like this. It goes here. So there are some different ways that we need to see. We need to keep our eyes and ears open that what we can do for our brand. Next is crisis communication. I don't want to take PSI's example in crisis communication. So there is this story that I want to tell. Tech Mahindra is a very well-known company, IT company. So there was this guy, his name is Gaurav Prober Pramanik. He was working with the company in 2015. Because of some reason, he said that I want to leave the company, and he did. And later in 2018, on 6th of September, when Indian Penal Code decriminalized Section 377 and accepted LGBTQ, accepted that, okay, it's okay to get married in the, you know, same sex. So that was fine. So this guy gathered his guts and wrote an email to Tech Mahindra's employee that you were the reason, you made me feel this way. You used to make derogatory comments on me. That is why I had to leave the company, and I left. And this lady, ironically, was a diversity officer. So on such, you know, she was here and she was doing this, and diversity officer. So she did not reply. She did not respond to the email. Then later he took that to Twitter. He posted on Twitter and tagged Tech Mahindra, and bam, it was a big crisis. Because Tech Mahindra has such a, you know, good image in media and market. And suddenly it was a very big deal for the client. So what we did, because we had to handle the crisis, we had to deal with the crisis in the best possible manner at that time. So first and foremost, the senior officials like CP Gurnani and, you know, Anand Mahindra, all these senior officials came into the picture. They tweeted saying that we will look into the matter. They did not immediately say that, okay, you know, we are sorry and all of that. That wasn't required, because they have to be sure. They were like, if this event, if the, you know, the story, he's just making it up to get more publicity, there could be a possibility of that as well. So they commented that we'll get into the matter, and we'll see that if the story is true and all of that. They did. Post that, the story was true when they, you know, investigated the issue. It was true. They threw that lady out. They sacked her. They apologized to the guy, and then they offered him the job. They said, we are apologetic about whatever happened, and it is very, very important. It is very important that you apologize for whatever you do. If it's your mistake, you have to apologize, right? So they apologized at such senior position they did. Post that, they said the HR people came into picture. They said that we are coming up with such, you know, environment, and we don't want something which is against Tech Mahindra's ethos. We accept diversity. So they said all of that, and for straight 6 months, they just did not, you know, just push the crisis, and they were like, okay, the spring was back and now they don't have any relation with it or something like that. For straight 6 months, they talked about diversity, they talked about uniqueness, they talked about acceptance in different publications. Everywhere they were talking about that we accept, we are giving a kind of environment which is healthy for our employees. That made a lot of difference. And that guy was feeling very happy. He was contented that the issue that was there in 2015, and that because of that, his mental health was affected. He was happy. And that then this lady was also thrown out. So the expectation was that there will be all negative story. However, there were total 103 coverage. Out of that, 18 were positive, 74 were neutral. So it's, you know, the balance we can see. Otherwise, 103 could have been negative, but that did not happen because the crisis was dealt well. So it's very important when there is any negative strategy, negative crisis comes up, we should never say that, okay, we'll look into the matter, or, you know, no comments. You always have to say that we'll look into the matter and we'll get back to you. You always have to be very, like, you have to be very prompt with the communication. Whatever you are saying, you just can't say and blow off. That is something that you can't do. So it's very, very important that you can't be arrogant. You have to be very realistic and handle it in the most affirmative manner. And you have to reassure and fair investigation is required, brand reputation management, because just one incident can also ruin the image of the brand that takes like many years to build, right? So it's very, very important to handle the crisis in the best possible manner if you can do. And there are times when you just can't handle, then you have to mum. But at the same time, that depends on what exactly has happened. Another crisis, I love crisis communication. So that's why I just keep on talking about crisis. So another crisis happened in 2017 in March. There was this Chinese employee named Suhao. He had no idea, or he did it purposely, or we don't know. So he tore the Indian flag, put it in the dustbin. And that became a very, very big news. Oppo, such a well-known player, if somebody is doing something like that, you can just think of that, you know, it hurts Indian sentiments. You can't tore a flag and put it in the dustbin. So that guy was sacked immediately. Post that, they rolled out the document that if you are working in India, what all you have to take care of? What are the things that you need to be very, very sensitive about? So everything was handled at that time, and the image was controlled. Otherwise, if they did not have taken any action against that guy, people might have stopped using Oppo altogether. Because Indian media is very strong, and Indian audience is super emotional. So we have to be on top of everything before we position and before we say anything. So by now, I want you guys to understand that why any brand should invest into PR, though I have told you a lot of reasons. However, to sum this up, your brand gets the voice that is required. You get an exclusive strategy. You get marketing activities along with PR, like there is a complement. Then multiple coverage. In less money, you get multiple coverage. Exclusive strategy for your brand. If A is working for you, strategy A is working for you, then you can't go for strategy B. You have to understand that what your brand demands at this point in time. You get media training. If the spokesperson is not ready to face the media, to face the journalist, you'll get media training beforehand. You'll be told that these are the kind of questions, these are the indicative questions that might come, and you have to prepare yourself in that manner. And at the time of interaction also, the PR person is there, because that person knows that, you know, how media reacts, how media can, like, one of your statement can ruin the entire story, because they need masala at the end of the day. So it's very, very important that, you know, you are media trained before you go in front of the media, or you go for email interviews or something like that. So therein, yeah, the PR person will be there and guide you that what should be the roadmap for the coming 3 months or 6 months, basis the need of your brand, basis how well you are trained. They also keep you apprised about your competitors. You don't have the time, since you are in that mindset wherein you just want to build your brand. You can't be on top of everything, that what your competitors are doing and all of that. But that is very, very much required. You have to understand that, you know, if I might come up with strategy B that my competitor is using in a tweaked manner, in a modified manner, might be that works for you. So it's very, very important to research that what your competitors are doing. And that research is also done by your PR person. They help you if there is any crisis, they help you control that crisis. They beat advertising. Public relations has beaten advertising. I'm not saying it's not important, but public relations beats advertising. CSR initiative. If you want to do anything, let's say PSI only. Let's take an example of PSI. So let's say PSI wants to conduct free trainings for girls. For a particular region, they want to do free trainings. That is worth, like, first of all, that news is important for PSI to get featured, like that can make sense for them, first and foremost. Second, it is something that should reach to people. They should know that, okay, you are coming up with something like this, and that can help people. So there are various ways. Like this is one of the CSR initiatives that just came to my mind, and I said, so these are the things that you can do, and they help you, let you know that this is the CSR initiative that you should use at this point in time, because at this time this will work. During the COVID times, I can't suggest my client to go out and do something like which can affect his health, and you know, which can also ruin the client's image or brand's image. So it's very, very important to understand that what will work at what point in time. Create partnership within your community. They help you reach to your community only. And it's a one-time payment to your strategist. You don't have to, like, for each and every coverage. Let's say in the month, you have got 5 coverage. 5 different publications have covered you. You don't have to pay per coverage to them. There is a stipulated amount that is discussed beforehand. You just give it, and then it's done. And on top of everything, there are a lot of tantrums of the journalist. I'm sorry if there is any journalist in the community at this point in time. So there are a lot of tantrums that the journalists have, because obviously they also don't have the time. They also don't, like, they are getting multiple calls in a day. They, for the same thing, for the same brand, they get multiple calls. So that's why they don't have the time to invest into you. So that tantrums that, you know, you might have to face doesn't come to you. It goes to your PR person. So I believe this is what I say, that never lie to your doctor, never lie to your lawyer. It's well known, like everybody knows. And I say that never lie to your doctor, never lie to your lawyer, and never ever lie to your PR consultant, because the person who is crafting an exclusive strategy for you should know the pulse of your brand. How can, now this is something that I've created exclusively for all of us. Because I know that every time we are not ready to invest, we think that, okay, perhaps we want to invest after 3 months or 6 months. So there are ways that you can do PR for yourself. Obviously, that won't be that effective. However, you should, like, you can do something by your own to start with. Understand your target audience. You know your target audience more than you, nobody would know. You know your brand. If I am selling this notebook, let's say, so I know that this is my target audience, I am well aware of. So you have to understand your target audience, and you have to discover the brand story. The brand story behind this is, I don't know if you have seen or not, but it is Friend's notebook. And Friend is one of the most watched series. So I have to understand, I have to discover my brand story. Then keep your social media update. If you're doing a single thing, if you have got covered by any publication, if you have done something which is worth telling, which is worth sharing, always craft a story. Just don't put caption, ki hum yahan par cover hue. Nahin. Try and craft a story and then post it on social media. Use your LinkedIn very effectively, use your Instagram very effectively. And if Facebook is, like, Facebook has your audience, understand from where you're getting the most business. So just put the content in the best possible manner there, and try and always use storytelling, because that works best. Weave stories. Then connect with the journalist. If you know somebody in your peer group or in your community, just reach out to that publication. Maybe it's a small publication for that matter. Just reach out to them that, okay, we are doing this event. We are, you know, we do this, we do that. Maybe that is not relevant right now, but after 6 months, 7 months, 5 months, they might want to cover you, because that is going in sync with their story. So it's not always that we need journalists. There are times when journalists, media also need us. So we have to understand that it's a give and take relationship. It's not about only us reaching to the media. They can also reach. However, we need to cultivate that relationship. Then there are a lot of webinar and networking events these days. So if you are getting invited to any of the networking event, or if you are getting an opportunity to go as a guest only, just go. Just make sure that you're attending these webinars if that is, you know, making sense for you, if that is effective for you. You don't know from where you can get business, and you never know that, you know, networking is very, very important. Like, very important. Maybe you don't like it, but it's very important if you want your PR to be done. And leverage every small or big opportunity. Just, you know, celebrate, embrace each and everything and embrace each and everything in the best manner on social media. It's very, very important for people. They think that, okay, it is show off and all of that. And it is somewhat. However, if you want your brand to reach that, like if you're getting business from social media and if you're not updating your social media at the same time, then there is something, there is a scope, there is a room for scope. Then content development, I already covered it in the previous slide. However, if your audience is coming from LinkedIn, just write articles. If you can't, get somebody on board and write articles from your, you know, from your industry. Talk from, let's say, PSI only. Talk about public speaking, that why it is important. Go Insta, do Instagram Live, Facebook Live, LinkedIn Live and whatnot. It's very, very important. There are times when we are like that, okay, let it be. We don't want to go live, or maybe only 4 people will join or whatever. However, it's very important because you don't know. Out of those 4 people, there would be one person who want your services. So if you're, I'm reiterating myself, if you're getting business from social media, or if there is a potential of getting business from social media, if you're not getting at this point in time, you will get it later. Just leverage it effectively. LinkedIn profiling, very, very, very important. So I have kept an example, like I was talking about PSI. This is my brand. This was my brand, Famous Seeks Candid Talk Show. I used to host this show. So we, like, 3 people met in a networking group and they were like-minded. They started with a channel called Famous Seek. We used to invite all the Sikh personalities from different professions to share their story. And it was like, they were not only talking about Sikhi and, you know, religion. They were Sikh, but the topics were like success, failure, inspiration, motivation and whatnot. So it was all about effectively telling your story. And if your story has a substance, we will cover you. So we used to host this show. We did like 20-21 episodes. And it used to go on Facebook. So you might be thinking that there are a lot of episodes, you know, there are a lot of webinars and whatnot come. So inko kaun hi cover karega? But we got covered because we had the strategy. I used to host this show. And we got covered in publications like APN News, 10 News. We interviewed Manmeet Singh. He is from, you must have seen this person in Rab Ne Bana Di Jodi or Band Baja Barat. Mr. Jitender Singh Shanti, he is a well-known politician. He has done a lot during the COVID times. Then Lieutenant General Balbir Singh Sandhu, we got covered in Decoding. Decoding is also one of the publications, digital publications. So he is a retired lieutenant and he shared his story, and that was mind-boggling. I have learned so much during this time. This is Mr. K.S. Aluwalia. He was a mentor. Like, recently, we lost him. Then there is this Parvinder Singh. He's a well-known comedian. He was the finalist in Great Laughter when Akshay Kumar was there. So this is a strategy. Like, if you have, every week we are doing the similar, similar thing. However, we need to understand that how we can project, because every week there is no possibility of getting covered in Times of India, but there could be a possibility of getting covered in a smaller publication, and that smaller publication will also create impact. And now if I'm getting covered in smaller publication, I'm sure after 5 months, I will be covered by Times of India as well. It is just a matter to start right now. There is this publication called The Harpreet Show. He does interviews on YouTube and he invites people from all over globally. He's based out of Canada. So while we were interviewing people, we did not reach out to him. He reached out to us. And he said that if you would like to be a part of our show and share your journey. So that was quite insightful. And we learned a lot in this process. So before I end, I want to say, it's not said by me. It's said by a well-known American author, Mr. Seth Godin, people do not buy goods and services. They buy relations, stories, and magic. So just create stories, weave stories, and understand what your brand has, what your brand can share. You have to cull out opportunities. Opportunities will not come to you. You have to literally scout them. So that's from my end. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Manpreet ji. You actually told a very interesting thing that people buy relations, strategies, and magic.
Thank
and
you
yes,
so much.
You actually delivered that magic as well. You differentiated marketing and PR very effectively. And everybody, I'm sure, is mesmerized with what you have told. The content was so elaborate that even though there was less time, but it was all effectively communicated to everyone. That was a wonderful session. Thank you very much for enlightening all of us. And dear all, we have the poll coming up. And in the meantime, you can poll up as well.
If there is any question, just let me know. I don't know what.
In case there is any question, you may please let me know.
Okay.
So that we can communicate it with Manpreet ji, or you can unmute yourself and ask it live.
I have a question, Manpreet. Hi, this is Gaurav this side, Gaurav Jain. And just a very quick question that according to your experience, how much time does it take to become a brand?
Startups are also doing PR. And, you know, big corporates are also doing PR. So it's just the matter of starting. And at least you need to give like 6 months to get covered, because PR is a slow process, however, very effective. Advertising, mein aap jaate ho, aapne 2 lakh diye, 3 lakh diye, aapko Times of India mein first page pe wo cover kar lenge, chahe aapka brand is... abhi is like, I don't want to use that word, like at this point in time, that is credible or not. So, but in PR, we create stories and we create it very effectively, that it takes time. However, it is very effective.
Okay.
So you have to invest in people, you have to invest time, and it's all about like investing into your brand, investing into your baby brand.
Okay, lovely. Thank you.
Thank you, Manpreet ji. Gaurav ji, I would also like to say something.
Yeah, Deepak, I would like to say something with your permission.
Yes, please, sir.
Yeah, it was a wonderful session, Manpreet. I thoroughly enjoyed all the key inputs you have given today. And I think it's going to benefit a lot of people who are thinking of starting their personal brands or thinking of entering into the sphere of public relations. And you have explained everything beautifully. Well done.
Thank you so much, sir. Before there is any other question, I really want to mention, I have learned from sir only. He's my mentor. And I wasn't that good any time. I'm not sure that I was good or not. However, that was something that was not possible for me some time back. And 6 months straight, he trained me. And I've come to this point wherein I literally like every day I take workshops. So thank you so much, sir.
Great. Yes, please. Anybody else who would like to say something? Or have any question to ask?
Yes. Hi, Manpreet. I'm Super Suresh ji from Chennai.
Hi, Suresh ji.
Yes, all your words will come into reality very quick, because you are just listing out about PSI. And definitely it is going to be a very good, because all your words will come into reality very soon, because even Arthur Sherry sir is my mentor. Before I used to fade away from the camera, but now I can able to face the camera and talk to you with more grace and courage. And PSI is really transforming many lives. And soon PSI will also come up with CSR activity, which you told that is very important, right?
It is. And to start with, I heard you in one of the competitions and you were awesome. I must say, I heard you. So yeah. And talking about PSI as a brand, it has already become a brand. It is already a brand and it has a lot of potential to reach. And talking about PSI, we say that, you know, we create, if we are saying it again and again, the universe is listening. It's all about affirmations. So,
yes,
yeah,
you are true. See, PSI was a platform which made me to watch me as well, right? So PSI and always Author Sherry sir provides platform to the people. See, I come from a very remote village in Tamil Nadu, but I don't know, but by God's grace, I connected with him. And see, Manpreet, you sit somewhere in North India and you came to know about me through the awesome platform. Thank you, Manpreet.
That's true.
Great, Manpreet ji, great, super bro. And with all this, we have so many mentees of Author Sherry, sir. I would like to say a few lines. Sir, with your permission, please. Yeah, it says, Jo seekhta gaya, wo jeetta gaya. Yes, sir.
Yes, please continue, Deepak, no problem.
Jo seekhta gaya, wo jeetta gaya. Jisne bhi roke apne kadam, wo jahan tha, wahin tham gaya. जिसने भी रोके अपने कदम वो जहां था वहीं थम गया इसलिए वो रुका नहीं हर रोज नए लक्ष्य बनाता रहा इसलिए वो रुका नहीं हर रोज नए लक्ष्य बनाता रहा खुद तो वो निखरा ही साथ में औरों को भी निखारता गया औरों को भी निखारता गया थैंक यू सैरी शेर यू आर एनलाइटिंग एवरीवन
Thank you, Deepak, for your nice words. God bless you.
Thank you very much, sir. And sir, I would request you to do the honors, so to felicitate our speaker for today.
Sure. Thank you so much, Manpreet, for this remarkable session. I think it is going to add a lot of value to all the people who are going to watch this recording as well. You have truly contributed on the topic and made full justice. We can't offer you much at present, but we would like to surely honor you with this digital certificate of appreciation. Please accept our heartfelt gratitude for your kind presence.
It was my pleasure, sir. Thank you so much to you. Thank you so much to Kara ma'am, Deepak sir, and Suresh ji, everybody, for giving me an opportunity to deliver a session here. And it delivering a session here was like coming back to home, you know. So, thank you so much for that.
Great. Thank you for your work. So, now we come to an end of the session. So it's 9:15 now. And before we end the session today, I would like to apprise everyone that we have some big events coming up. So, please do stay actively tuned for more information on PSI official group on the WhatsApp as well as on the Facebook page of PSI and LinkedIn. Stay safe, stay blessed, use mask, sanitizer, and maintain physical distancing. Have a wonderful and lovely, lovely weekend. Thank you very much, everyone. Stay blessed, stay blessed. Have a lovely weekend. Bye-bye for now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. God
bless you. Good night.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Manpreet.
Pleasure. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.